So some talk from the corner of Stevie Cruz, and here's a look at round eight action.
As you mentioned, Randy, he's slugging, he's boxing. He's pretty much in control the entire round. He's doing what he wants to do, and Stevie's got to figure it out while it's going on.
Most of those punches did not get in, but you saw, despite the fact that Stevie Cruz is doing some nice defense, he was not throwing any punches back at Asparagos.
Well, it's time for Stevie Cruz to make a move because he's way behind on our scorecard. And this is about one, as I said before, the middle rounds with McGuigan key in the fight back in June.
Neutral judges here tonight. There was a lack about that before the fight. Stevie Cruz wanted somebody from the state of Texas as one of the scoring judges, but according to the WBA, you must have four neutral officials, and we do tonight. Ishmael Fernandez is our referee.
Donald Curry got up from his chair, came over to the Cruz corner, whispered something in Mad Dog Hatcher's ear over there, and I'm sure there'll be some, once again, the Cruz committee getting together after this round.
Well, I think they're still very much, they feel like they are still very much in this fight, no doubt about it, behind on points, but Cruz at times does show flashes of excellence.
Unfortunately, they are just flashes. Asparagos has been showing a flash about 180 seconds every round.
Mm-hmm.
He just looks so good doing anything he wants to do. And he said at the top of the show, the challenger has come here to take the title.
He's not getting big bucks for it, but he's certainly ready for big bucks, and he looks as good as this in his future fights.
Cruz got a hometown majority decision over Victor Acosta in 1984. Should this go the distance? Again, the home crowd favoritism might sway, but right now, definitively, we do have Asparagos ahead on points. We're in round nine.
Fans who have seen world-class Johnny De La Rosa. Well, Johnny De La Rosa was knocked out, I mean savaged, by Asparagos about 2 years ago. That gives you a clue that the man can fight. And then, of course, watching him here tonight, you know that this is a featherweight who will be around for some time to come, as long as he decides to stay in this kind of shape.
He almost looks like if he had to put on 4 pounds, 4 or 6 pounds, Randy, I'm curious with this kind of frame at 5'8", 5'9", he probably could jump up the weight class.
Asparagos with a forced smile, and now he's being assessed.
White was a deducted. And the hometown crowd says it's just about time. Dave Gorman finally getting his wish over here in the corner.
So it's another round that I believe Asparagos is winning. So at the end, I wind up scoring this at 10-9, and if you're scoring at home, score it 10-9. Take that point away, you can call it an even round. That's if you decide that Asparagos is winning the round.
Looking for that scorecard, doubleheader May 1st, Binklin Thomas in action, although James Buster Douglas has business against Tony Tucker, and of course, Edwin Rosario.
Coming
here's
up.
The low blow.
Right. Coming up right.
Right uppercut.
Ooh. Yeah, as you said, below the border, Randy.
That was a bit, that wasn't towards Caracas, that was like Maracay.
It's not unusual for the champion to go to the hometown of the challenger. This fight coming to Fort Worth, though, through the efforts of Josephine Abercrombie and the Houston Boxing Association.
Well, Nancy Reagan might be the first lady of this country. Josephine Abercrombie, the first lady of boxing. On my unofficial scorecard, I've got Stevie Cruz behind by 6 points. That means if this should go 15 rounds, he has to win this round and every other round just to salvage a draw.
Well, the draw is one thing Asparagos does not want. He's drawn 3 times, including once against Bernardo Checa. It'll beat Checa. Cruz still looks unfazed, though. He comes back after every bell and sets up camp and goes right back to work, although we haven't seen the blood from under his eye just yet.
But the swelling is certainly there, and I think the eyesight, as Randy mentioned, is certainly going to be a factor. It can't be that good, and you're kind of waiting for Antonio to unload on that left hook, because you got to wonder if Steve would see it coming.
I'm really surprised Espargosa is not opening up to the head with double and triple hooks, because even if he throws a triple hook and one gets in, or if two miss, one still will get in. He's just probing with the jab, throwing a lot of body shots, but leaving the head alone with a hook.
Cruz got him in the corner. Just watch. Espargosa does a nice spin job and gets out of it.
Espargosa has done that a couple of times, gotten out of trouble, and now turns the tables. He's got Cruz backed up now. Cruz fighting with his mouth open just a little bit. That's always a bad sign.
We mentioned that herky-jerky movement of a lot of the Venezuelan fighters, and from time to time, you see Espargosa do it. He steps to either side, up
right,
and down, in and out. You never know where he's going to come from next.
Espargosa stalking. He stalks his opponent. He's a very savvy fighter. You can see him planning his shots.
Cruz is reaching deep down inside himself now. He knows that title is slipping away.
...20 seconds to go. Here in round 10, we'll go 15 if need be for Cruz to defend his title. Both fighters with only one loss apiece. We'll be back in just a minute. Stay with us, everybody.
It's a sorry picture over there in the other round. Steve Cruz, as we mentioned before, the end of the round. Espargosa, every time Cruz gets something together, Espargosa just raises the level of his competition and goes in and gets Antonio.
Back for round 11, John Lawson, Randy Gordon, Hugh Millay. We ought to mention the victory over McGuigan by Cruz, surrounded by two mediocre performances. The split win over Rocky Garcia in 85, followed by that 10-round non-title win over Roger Arevalo. So Cruz certainly trying to impress the fans tonight, the boxing experts, the judges, his wife, and himself, because he does have something to prove tonight. His first real shot with his defense.
Give a round of applause so far to one of the cornermen of Stevie Cruz, Ron Hatcher, the father of former junior welterweight champ Gene Hatcher. He's using that end swell device absolutely perfect. He's leaning on it, and then you lean on it for about 8 or 10 seconds hard, and then you slide it back towards the ear, and it takes the fluid called the edema and moves it back into the cavity and out of the swelling area. And so far, that swelling is staying down. But Cruz had better get to work.
Those are shots of Cruz, not Booze, although sometimes you wouldn't know. Cruz has had his problems tonight, but he's been hanging in there, and right now he's taking Espargosa into the 11th round.
Espargosa has just thrown so many punches, as Randy said, from so many different angles. The guy is just a puzzle to figure out, and he reminds me a lot of Bernardo Penango from the aspect, these guys, you never know where they're coming from, and they slip a punch so well, and he changes stances so well.
There, he threw a shot with some bad intentions on it, and then he just stepped away. And so many of the shots that the challenger is throwing, they do have bad intentions.
Espargosa's right thigh initialed AE. Antonio Espargosa, he is Venezuela's hero tonight. We've got him ahead after 10 rounds of activity.
Well, fighter's looking a little sloppy here in the 11th round. As soon as I say that, Antonio makes it look bad.
Well, this is uncharted territory for Espargosa. He's never gone more than 10.
Bang, 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 bang. I mean, one after another. Espargosa letting both guns go.
Up over the top, around the corner, underneath. Espargosa finds a way at will.
Trying to finish it up right here in 11. Unload some nice right. But Cruz, as you mentioned, Randy, taking some vicious shots and keeps on coming back.
Cruz in excellent shape. And as you fellas have mentioned earlier, that's going to be his saving grace as we get into the waning rounds here. And again, Ishmael Fernandez steps in because this Bill Grizzle wants more.
Antonio had a good time that round. He turned to the corner and just kind of smiled. He was just joking. I don't think he was going to hit him after that, at the end of that round.
Asparagoza's manager, Ricardo Maldonado, Pedro Avila, is his trainer working on